Bert Johnson was here earlier and said the Democratic caucus leader in the Senate, and he said, I guarantee it's going to be the other way around next year. Tell me, you say,
Yeah, guarantee. That's an interesting choice of words. Look, we had record success, and there's no question about it, and a lot of things went our way. We had great candidates, and we raised lots of money, and the wind was at our back. But we're just as optimistic going into the next cycle. We will raise the dollars. We've got great people looking at up and down the ticket. Obama's helping us out. Stabenow's helping us out. And as we look forward to 12, we're going to be ready and we're going to be competitive. And I suspect that the other gentleman might wish those words guaranteed were not in his statement.
Debbie Stabenow, you mentioned helping you out, as you put it. You've been seeking a candidate. Some of the bigger names, Pete Hoekstra, Terry Lynn Land, have said no. Is there something about the race with Debbie Stabenow that is turning off the big names in the Republican Party?
I don't think it's turning off the names. I'd summarize it this way. It's still early. This is June. Normally, all the candidates are lined up by mid to late fall. So call that end of September, which coincides with this year with our biannual leadership conference back up here on the island. The four or five names that are surfacing are great names and very competitive. All of them have the possibility of winning a primary. Debbie Stabenow is her votes have helped us. She's down the line supporting the health care bill, obviously. The debt limit is going to be a big question mark where she comes out on that. And as you look back and you look forward, she's vulnerable, and we intend to take full advantage of that.
And what about the presidential candidate, President Obama's re-election chances? Some say that he is unbeatable. Others say, no, it's just the opposite.
I think the president's agenda, particularly in Michigan and around the country, is not aligning with where the country's at today. The stimulus plan didn't work. It didn't create the jobs. Certainly no long-term. The numbers just came out, you know, the other day, yesterday, I think, showed it again, unemployment going in the wrong direction. So he's vulnerable, and policy decisions they've made on the Mideast and other things of late have been helpful, I think, to Republicans.
But he got Bin Laden.
He got Bin Laden. Give him credit for that. But I think George W. Bush deserves some credit for that as well.
Great to see you. Thanks for coming by. Bobby Schostak, the chair of the Michigan Republican Party.